So today in this video we're gonna talk about hydrolysis of salt made up of the reaction of weak acid with a strong base. So what actually hydrolysis is? So in a salt, when cationic or anionic or we can say both part react with water, so this is called hydrolysis. So either when cationic, anionic or both part react with water. So when we are talking about the case specifically where we are talking about the salt made up of the reaction of weak acid and strong base. So example, if we take the example, what are the example of these type of salt? So first of all, we are talking about sodium acetate. It is made up of reaction of sodium hydroxide, which is a strong base, and acetic acid, which is a weak base. Sodium cyanide, NaNO2, sodium nitrite, Na, sodium fluoride, etc. So here all the salt made up of reaction of strong base with weak acids. So in the hydrolysis of this that we are going to study. So first of all dissolved salt in H2O. All when salts we are dissolving in H2O. Here we have H2O and we are dissolving here. So we consider this salt as a strong electrolytes. These electrolytes are considered as a strong electrolyte. When what do we mean by strong electrolyte? We mean by strong electrolyte like if we are putting the salt in aqueous medium, so they're gonna dissociate whole. It will gonna form acetate ion and sodium plus. So if we are taking that T equals to 0, the concentration is C. So after time that will mean totally consumed and it will form the concentration of C and C. So here the concentration of acetate we are getting C and sodium we are getting C. So whenever we are talking about the, now if you see the what happens here, the acetate ion gonna react with water and sodium also gonna react with water. So when we talk about we are reacting the sodium with water, so what when sodium react with water? Na plus H2O, it is forming NaOH plus H plus, and we know NaOH further gonna give Na plus plus OH minus plus H plus. So here part of whatever is the part of a strong acid or a strong base that are known as spectator ion. Spectator ion means they will be spectator over here. They won't be participate in the hydrolysis because when they are a part of a strong acid or a strong base and they are going to participate, so they will form the same compound. They won't be hydrolyzed further. So here we gonna talk about when we are doing the anionic hydrolysis. So here the cationic part was made up of strong base, so it won't be participate in the hydrolysis. So whenever we are talking anionic hydrolysis, so pH in this case pH will always be greater than 7. So whenever we are talking about the anionic hydrolysis, so pH will be greater than 7 at temperature when we are considering the 25 degrees Celsius. So that is the anionic hydrolysis we are going to take. So here we are talking when we are doing the anionic hydrolysis, and then here if we see the acetate ion reacts with water and it form acetic acid plus hydroxide ion in aqueous state. So now if you see at equilibrium, the concentration we have taken already C. We have already seen that we have taken the concentration of acetate, sodium acetate C. Now acetate ion we are getting the concentration See, now we are talking about it will dissociate like 1 minus H and it will forming CH and it is also forming CH. Now, whenever we are talking about it is actually a base. So, what we can write KB of CH3COO minus or it is also written as a K hydrolysis. Okay, here also we can write hydrolysis. So, when we are writing the hydrolysis equation, so according to law of mass action, here will be the concentration of acetic acid, hydroxide ion divided it by concentration of acetate ion in aqueous medium, that will be the KH, the hydrolysis. This is known as hydrolysis constant, and the H we are using here, that is known as degree of hydrolysis, that is known as degree of hydrolysis. So this is known as degree of hydrolysis and this is known as hydrolysis constant. So if you write the equation KH, if you put all these values in the concentration, we will get it CH square divided by 1 minus H. Like we have previously take example, we use alpha, like that was degree of ionization, okay, degree of dissociation. So here in case of hydrolysis, we use the term small h. So now if we see, we know the KW. So KW comes out to be KB of acetate ion multiply by KA of acetic acid. So when we know that KW equals to KA multiply by KB. So KA and KB, they both belong to same molecule or same compound. Okay, like if KA we are talking about acetic acid, then KB should be the conjugate base. It's conjugate base. Okay, now so here we will getting the KH. So if you write the value of KH, that comes out to me. So if you want to write the value of KH, what could be the value of KH? So if you write the equation, like if you write how the acetic acid is dissolving, if you write the equation CH3COO minus in aqueous reacting with H plus and forming acetic acid in aqueous. So what is the constant, the equilibrium constant of this equation? That we know as, this is 1 by KA. This is the KA equation and it is the reverse of KA. Now if you write H2O in liquid state forming H plus in aqueous state plus OH minus in aqueous state. So what is that? That is actually KW. Now if we do the summation of these two equilibrium, now H2O, H plus 2 H plus will get cancelled. It will form acetate ion in aqueous plus H2O in liquid, that is in equilibrium with acetic acid in aqueous plus OH minus in aqueous. So here we know that is KH, that is the equation KH, and we have added both the equation. When we add to equilibrium, then constant gets multiplied, so that is coming out to be KW by KA. Now every time whenever we see any hydrolysis, we have to find out three values. One is KH, one is H, and one is pH. So we have to find all this value. One is KH, one is degree of hydrolysis, one is hydrolysis constant, and one is the pH of the solution. So let's say we see this hydrolysis. Now when we are seeing this hydrolysis, how should we write the KH? KH should be equals to KWN divided it by, we will divide the constant of this, the whatever we have in the right hand side or product side. So here we have acid, so we'll write the KA. Now let's see another example. If we have given the hydrolysis HPO4 minus 2 will react with H2O and it will be forming H2PO4 minus plus H2O. So this is again a hydrolysis. So how we will write the KH? So we will writing KH equals to KW divided it by. If we see, this is the KA2. K1 was H3PO4 was converting into H2PO4. Now if you see the reverse of this equation, this equation is going to KA2. So here we will writing the KA2. Or if we have given the phosphate PO4 minus 3 plus H2O, that is in dynamic equilibrium with HPO4 minus 2 plus H2O. Now it will be HPO4 minus 1. So how we will write KHCO? You know, it is again hydrolysis. So we will look whatever we have in the reactant side. So we have here the product side. Product side we have that acid. So how it is dissociating? It is dissociating with Ka3. And we see this reverse equation, that is Ka3. So we will write like Ka3. So that's how we will we can write the hydrolysis constant, the KH, in a single step. Now here we have got KH equals to KW by Ka. Now if you see the equation, the acetic acid, the equation over here. So if you put the value over here, so KH we will get equals to C alpha square. We will get the KH as C alpha square, considering alpha is less than 0.05. So in divided by 1 minus alpha, we will neglect that alpha. So here alpha we will get, that will be equals to under root over KH upon C. Now that is the value of alpha we are getting. So what is the value of KH? KH we have already seen, the value is under root over KW by KA multiply by C over here. So that's how we will get the value of KH. Now if we see the concentration of OH minus, if we see here what is the concentration of OH minus we are getting, that is also equals to C alpha. Now we have got the value of C. Now what is the value of alpha? Alpha will be KW by KA multiply by C. Now if we see that is 2 under root 2 multiplication of under root 2 C. Okay, so that will get cancelled here. So it will be coming out KW into C divided by KA over here. Now if you look at further, that is the concentration of OH minus we get. So what we will getting POH over here. So POH we will be getting, it equals to 1 by 2 PKH minus log C. That will be the POH of the solution. Now what is the concentration of OH minus here? Now we know what is the concentration of H plus into OH minus, that comes out to me KW. Now we know the value of OH minus, we know the KW. Now how we will get the H plus? So here concentration of H plus equals to KW divided by concentration of OH minus. So KW, what is the concentration of OH minus? Here that is the concentration of OH minus. That value we gonna put over here. So that comes out to be KW into C divided by KA. So if we solve the whole, the concentration of H plus is coming out to be under root over KA into KW divided by C. So that is the concentration of H plus we are getting. Now if we take minus log of H plus both side, so minus log of H plus if we take, that comes out to be 1 by 2 minus log of KA minus log of KW plus log of C. Now further pH, it will be pH. Now pH equals to 1 by 2, that is PKW, that is PKW plus PKA plus log of C. So now pH comes out to me, if you know what is the value of PKW, that is 7 at 25 degrees Celsius, that comes out to be PKA plus log of C. So we know that formula is valid when temperature is 25 degrees Celsius. Otherwise, this is the general formula of pH we could use when this is the hydrolysis of salt made up of strong acid, weak acid and a strong base. So where is the concentration of salt? C is the concentration of salt, that is the concentration of salt. Now this is the concentration of salt we know, and if we talk about the acetic acid, if it's not that much strong electrolyte, so CH3COO Na, like it is in aqueous state, like it is 90% dissociated, so it will form CH3COO minus plus Na plus in aqueous state. So where it is, like say it is, the dissociation is 90%, so it, the remaining will be 0.1 C, and it will be 0.9 C, it will be 0.9 C. So instead of C, we will be using 0.9 C. So if degree of dissociation, now not degree of dissociation, if we talk about the electrolyte is not perfectly the pure means the not that much strongest electrolyte, then instead of C we will use the value of 0.9 multiplied by C. So here that's how we will look how to solve hydrolysis, calculate the pH, calculate the KH, calculate the hydrolysis constant and degree of hydrolysis in case of salt made up of weak acid and strong base.